and with staff. I can see that we've got a full house. This is a special meeting of the coordinating committee, and so I'd like to welcome everybody and those people who come along, and take apologies for absence. I know there are quite a number of apologies. I've got Anita Leach, Mike Sullivan, Jeanette Williamson, Paul Doughty. Any others?
Andy Clements, Steve Williams.
That's all of us.
Okay. I think I need to give a brief explanation of what's going to happen tonight. This is the coordinating committee. The coordinating committee is responsible for listening to call-ins. Call-ins are a request by a group of members to scrutinise a decision made by the executive. And there are two requirements, really, for good scrutiny. And one is that it's done within a certain time period. The time period is 15 working days for hearing to be called. And the second responsibility for good scrutiny is that we have the people available to us to be able to question them, to listen to what they have to say, so that we can look in that in detail at that decision and then decide if we need to make recommendations about the decision. Now, we've been able to fulfil the first one in that we call the meeting to be held within 15 working days, but we're not able to fulfil the second requirement in that we can't get all the people together who need to be here. So for that reason, I'm going to go through the agenda. I'm going to first of all ask if there are any declarations of interest. Yes, Christina.
Chair, I declare the declaration of interest in both licences and the signatures of the calling on both. However, I can hear the mind will listen to all the evidence.
Actually, at the end of the meeting, I was going to ask, of course, the Director of Law if he'd give us some sort of steer on whether or not fairly should be. I said to the steer on what the situation was with regards to people who are signatories to the calling, but also members of this committee. So I was going to ask that. Thank you very much for that. I'm also going to make a request that everybody tell me that they are not subject to the party whip. Are you all able to do that? Good. As I say, this is within 15 working days for a call-in, but I'm now going to move on to the next item on the agenda, which is the call-in of a delegated decision covered within number 37, transformation of leisure services and sports. And I'm going to request the committee adjourn this meeting and reconvene on the 23rd of September to hear that call-in. Are we all agreed to that? Next item on the agenda is item 4 is call-in on the delegated decision cabinet meeting number 27, financial monitoring. I'm going to ask the committee to adjourn the meeting tonight and reconvene on the 18th of September. Are we all agreed to that?
No, Chairman, there's three members of this committee will be around on the 18th of September, so I'll ask for that to be put back to a Monday.
And I know that okay, thank you very much. And I know that you made that request yesterday. However, I did give it some thought, and I certainly did look at the dates available for the following week, which is when you requested that we put it back to.
Or to alternative.
Well, I understand you want that as well, or you've asked for that as well. And having, if you don't mind, I'll finish. Having looked at the dates available for the week and taken into consideration several things, I'm afraid that I'm going to have to ask if you can either change your diary arrangements or use the deputies as we have done tonight. And I have done that in the spirit of being inclusive, but if you need me to give the full explanation to riders, I'm more than happy to do that.
No, I'm happy to formally move that it's delayed until such time as we need to allow it for officers to be available to hear comment. I'm asking for the same for admitted to get two elected members.
And I understand.
So I'm formally moving that this meeting is put back.
Before I put it to the vote, Councillor Blakely, I'm going to go through the sequence of events that led me to make the decision not to change the dates to be put in the diary. And they are as follows. Cabinet met on the 7th of July and made a series of decisions. I was notified to call in. Two valid call-ins had been made on the 23rd of July. And I was asked on that day if I wanted to have two meetings or one, and what dates I was available within the next. I said I prefer to have one date and try and do the call-ins both on the same night, but I also gave the dates when I was available. On the 25th, officers came back and said that they had made inquiries among the people that were needed to be here, and that it was impossible to fit in dates within that 15 working day period. At that point, I asked the director of law how we're fitted in with the constitution if we were to call a meeting within the 15 days and adjourn it. And he said that complied with the requirements of the constitution. And I asked officers to contact the spokespersons and ask them if they were comfortable with that line of action. And to the best of my knowledge, everybody agreed that they were. I know Councillor Bakey at that time, you also made a request that we have two meetings instead of one. And I agreed to that. The next thing that happened was that we started to look at dates that were available. Now, two dates were brought forward for August, and I know that you said that you didn't feel one, I think you were available, and another you felt it wasn't an appropriate date. We asked you to supply dates when you weren't available, both the spokespersons and myself, and all the interested parties, and to the best of my knowledge, we all did. When we came, it took us now, looking at it week by week, it now took us to the 15th of September. There were no dates available that week. But standard on the 18th was cancelled. Since nobody had made us aware that they weren't available, when I say nobody, I mean the spokespersons, the call-in, the lead secretaries of the call-in, the relevant officers, the cabinet members. Nobody had said they weren't available that week, and therefore we agreed that that was the day that that meeting would be held. And the same for the 22nd, we looked at the following week, commencing the 22nd, there was only one day available for that week, that was the 23rd. Notice went out of that on the 1st of August, and to say what dates the adjournments were planned for. And they are now in the diary. When you made your request yesterday morning and saying that you weren't available, you didn't say that 3 months weren't available,
I'm not here to look up to the diaries of the other members of my group. I'm not going to go down to the diary tomorrow.
Detailing the logic that I used to say that we are going to stick with the decision that was made last week.
Chairman, I've moved that it's delayed beyond that date.
I'm going to now put it to the vote. Those in favour, ask the second up, please. You also. Second up for the recommendation of the move to the 18th. Second up that we move to the 18th. Yes?
Okay.
So all those in favour of the amendment of the proposal that we will qualify. Those against? Those in favour of the recommendation that we meet on the 18th of September, please show. And that's carried. Thank you very much.
There can be a call vote against.
I'm sorry?
There can be a call vote against.
Those against?
Can we call one, please?
Yes. Yes. I'm leaving it at that. So moving on to the next item of the business. I have got no urgent of any. But I would like to check with the Director of Law what is the status of members of the committee who are signatories to the call-ins and also members of the committee. Are they able to be part of the
committee? So we were when we had members calling this issue in the last aspect, and members were allowed to physically participate in the call-ins where they had the signatures. There were, however, representation by members of the committee that was the most effective one that would be the most appropriate. Way of conducting the call-in, I think there was a general consensus or being expressed that members who were signatories to the call-in ought not to be also engaged in any decision making in relation to that call-in. That was a general view that was expressed by many members. The general thrust of the advice was or view being expressed that in future we awarded that occurrence.
Well, Chairman, if I may, I've made a declaration, but I haven't, although I signed both call-ins, I have not made a decision. I have not been determined the outcome, and I will be participating in the committee.
I'm counseling.
I will be participating in the committee.
And I'm not going to
argue. It's allowed me to finish this, Chairman. I will be participating, but I can't participate in the committee the week before, because I will be.
And as I'm saying, anybody else who declares an interest, whether somebody declares an interest, not it is for them alone to decide at the end of the day and then take the consequences of that decision as a decision. And thank you very much for your attendance.